Hello guys, in this lecture we are going to see the boot sequence of Windows 10. So you are new to the channel, go and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any update from us. For today's lecture, I'll explain without PPT. I'm trying to explain with this image. So let's start. Now I'm going to tell you what is boot sequence. Boot sequence is an order in which computer search the data storage devices contain program code to load the operating system. Typically, Macintosh structure uses ROM and Windows structure uses BIOS to start boot sequence. Once instructions are found, the CPU takes control and load the OS into the system memory. The devices that are usually listed as a boot order option in BIOS setting are hard drive, floppy drive, optical drive, flash drive, etc. The user can change the boot sequence via CMON setup. The boot sequence is also called boot order or BIOS boot order. So as you can see on the screen, you can guess what is the boot sequence and how it works. Okay. So move to the boot sequence. There are three phases in boot sequence. First, BIOS phase. Second, BIOS loader phase. Third, kernel phase. Let's talk about BIOS phase. In BIOS phase, we powered on the system and that will start with two pre-boot window settings. First is UEFI boot and second is BIOS boot. UEFI boot sequence. First, we will discuss about UEFI boot sequence. Nowadays, most popular boot sequence to install OS. In UEFI boot, when we power down the system starts his first boot process, that is post powered on self test. The post process is run both the Windows and Macintosh computers. Post sequence check a vital hardware such as power supply, RAM and system bus. If the test is failed, the post process will be written an error message. The error message will be displayed on your screen, maybe output in the form of the beeps and blinking lights. When all the checks are done, then system launch UEFI firmware. I'll make another video to explain the difference between BIOS and UEFI. Let's move on. After launching UEFI, system collects the information from SRAM and NVRAM or CMOS. Wait, don't panic. I'll explain what these are. SRAM is a static RAM, is a random access memory that returns data bits in a its memory as a long power is being supplied. NVRAM stands for non-volatile random access memory. NVRAM is a type of RAM that returns the data after host device powered is turned off. Two common types of NVRAM include SRAM and EEPROM. Okay, so what is CMOS? CMOS is an alternative referred as a RTC, real-time clock, NVRAM, non-volatile RAM or CMOS RAM. CMOS is a short for complementary metal oxide semiconductor. CMOS is a onboard battery-powered semiconductor chip inside the computer that stores the information. If you see it on the screen, in the first phase, the display is blank, and if you are having any problem with the first phase, that is BIOS phase, so you got this type of errors. So it means there are some problem with your first phase. After gathering all the information, this process goes to the next phase. And next phase is bootloader phase. In this phase, first launch Windows Boot Manager. Then Boot manager read the BCD files. BCD stands for boot configuration data files. If all the configuration files are proper, then it's launch Windows boot loader. It means slash Windows slash system32 slash winload dot EFI. If you can see it on the screen, still our screen is blank. And if you have any issues in the bootloader phase, then you'll get this error, the BCD registry or driver file corruption error. So let's assume we don't have any error. So after the launching Windows bootloader, after that, load OS kernel into the memory. So now we are going to enter into the last phase, that is kernel phase. In a kernel phase, Windows launch NTOS kernel. So what is kernel? Kernel is a computer program at the core of the computer operating system with complete control over everything in the system. It is an integral part of any operating system. It is a portion of the operating system code that always resident in the memory. It facilitates interaction between hardware and the software component. On most system, it is one of the first program load on the setup after the bootloader. It handles the rest of the startup as well as input and output requests from the software, translating them into the data process instructions from the central processing unit. It handles memory and peripherals like keyboards, monitors, printers, speakers, etc. After this process, hardware driver is loaded and create device node to launch smss.exe. Then the process move to initializing subsystems like load win d32k.sys. And after that, its create user session process will launch. When we create and set up all the settings, then we will see the Windows login screen and its run the group policy script when the user logs in. Also, Windows create a session for that user. As you can see here, we'll get the lock screen and the user logon screen when our boot sequence, UEFI boot sequence process is completed. Now, let's look into the BIOS boot sequence. The first step is the same in the UEFI and the BIOS. When we powered on the system, then BIOS also start post powered on self-test. After post, it search for the boot device in your hard drive. Then it's load the MBR into a memory from the first sector of the hard drive. Here. So now you think, what is MBR? MBR is a short form of master boot record. Master boot record is also sometimes referred as the master boot blocks, master partition boot sector, and the boot sector zero. The MBR is the first sector of the computer hard drive. It tells the computer how the hard drive is proportionate and how to load the operating system. Then the bootstrap code of MBR searches the partition table to find the active partition. Then run the bootstrap code of PBR, partition boot record. After running bootstrap code, it search for the boot MGR and runs. Then our second phase is started, that is bootloader phase. then the boot manager launches means slash root percentage percentage slash boot mgr. Then it goes to read bcd files as like uefi. After system reads bcd files, then the Windows boot loader launches. After system reads bcd files, then the Windows boot loader launch, that is slash windows slash system 32 slash winload.exe. Then this process is also load OS kernel into the memory. After that, all the processes are same, like it's launch Windows NT OS kernel, then hardware emulation load driver and create device node launches smsss.exe, and it's initialize the subsystem means load win32k.sys. Then create the user session process, and then we will see the user log on screen as we will discuss it in UEFI boot sequence also. So that's it for today. Let's move to the next lecture. Thank you.